From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. The Bahamas government will receive the first batch of Oxford AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccines Sunday, according to a statement released by the Office of the Prime Minister today. The first set consists of a vaccine donation from the Indian government of 20,000 jabs, also known as Covishield. Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis has thanked the government of India for the donation on behalf of the Bahamian government and people of the Bahamas. The statement read, quote, "The vaccines were pre-qualified by the World Health Organization and received emergency use listing approval by the WHO. The vaccines have also received certification from the Caribbean Regulatory System. The donation is part of a commitment from India to donate a total of 500,000 doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine to Caribbean community countries." Dr. Minnis is expected to give a live update on the rollout of this first batch of vaccines on Sunday at 5 p.m. in a nationally televised address. Health Minister Renwood Wells yesterday suggested House Speaker Halsin Mutri does not have the sole authority to implement a Prime Minister's question and answer period in Parliament, telling reporters the rules of the House of Assembly are set by its members. This comes after Speaker Mutri on Wednesday said he was considering the matter and also warned members of Parliament to be on notice that the practice of the governing party avoiding questions will not continue. Asked if the government will support such a move if it becomes implemented, Mr. Wells, who is the leader of government business the House of Assembly, did not directly answer. He said parliamentarians make the laws on proceedings in the House of Assembly. The Court of Appeal held a rare full court hearing yesterday to consider Supreme Court Justice Ian Winder's historic ruling that children born out of wedlock to Bahamian men and foreign women are citizens at birth and do not have to wait until 18 to apply for citizenship. The case revolves around the interpretation of Article 6 of the Constitution. Currently, two inconsistent rulings exist on the matter, that of Justice Winder, which was issued in May of last year, and that of former Chief Justice Sir Burton Hall in 2009. If upheld, Justice Winder's ruling would have significant implications for citizenship rights. Education Loan Authority Chairwoman Miriam Emanuel says the authority has seen a 29% decline in the number of delinquent accounts, which now stands at nearly 3,500 loans. The decline was attributed in part to 37 people who paid off their student loans, totaling $467,702.78, Mrs. Emanuel said yesterday. Noting this marked decrease in Parliament, the Mike Hall MP said the ELA is ready to move forward with collection efforts on 3,294 files that have been prepared to date. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, the Senate seemingly killed progressives' last-ditch effort to include a minimum wage hike in the Democrats' $1.9 trillion COVID-19 relief bill Friday, as the chamber began climactic votes on the huge package embodying President Joe Biden's top legislative priority. Senators voted 58-42 against the increase, though the vote wasn't yet formally gaveled to a close. 8 Democrats voted against the proposal, suggesting that Senator Bernie Sanders, independent for Vermont, and other progressives vowing to continue to fight in the coming months will face a difficult fight. China is increasing its defense spending by 6.8% in 2021 as it works to maintain a robust upgrading of the armed forces despite high government debt and the impact of the coronavirus pandemic. A national budget report issued Friday said China would spend $210 billion on defense in the coming year. That's up from $180 billion last year, representing a 6.6% boost, the lowest percentage increase in at least two decades. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A frontal boundary is sitting across the southeast Bahamas while a surface trough is dissipating over the central islands. Beachgoers should be alert for possible rip currents in the northwest Bahamas. Mariners should be vigilant for possible waterspout activity during showers and thunderstorms. In the northwest Bahamas, it'll be variably cloudy, breezy, and mild, with the chance of an isolated shower becoming fair and cool tonight. Small craft caution continues. Winds northeasterly at 15 to 20 knots, falling 10 to 15 knots tonight. Seas 4 to 6 feet, subsiding 2 to 4 feet. In the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be partly cloudy to cloudy, humid and warm, with scattered showers and an isolated thunderstorm through tonight. Decreasing shower activity in the central islands tonight. Expect gusty winds and higher seas in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds northwest to north at 5 to 10 knots, falling light and variable at times. Seas 1 to 3 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 77 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 63. The sun will set this afternoon at 6:12 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:28. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets, or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.